वेलकम बैक गाइस, फ्रॉम टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर सेकेंड टर्म सिलेबस.
फाइन. एंड इन योर फर्स्ट टर्म द लीनियर इक्वेशन पार्ट हैव बीन टू सम एक्सटेंट हैव बीन एक्सप्लेन टू यू. सो सी, आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एक्सेस टू सी. ओके, लीनियर इक्वेशन टू वेरिएबल सेकेंड वेरिएबल. Fine. The linear equation in one variable we have very nicely discussed in class 7, and in first term also you this term has been explained very nicely how you can take out the roots of the equation, three roots, two roots, anything, something specific terms were given in the questions. Those are very easy. Okay, if you find any difficulty, please go through the first term syllabus that was taught to you in the video session. And you will be clear. Okay. See, linear equation, when a particular question comes as solveless equation. In exam, if I put a question without mentioning any particular specific rule, then you can go through any rule. But in your book, there are sufficient elementation, this cross multiplication and comparison. Four methods are given. So it will be very good for you if I explain you all the the processes. And if I don't mention it, or if the question do not demand any specific method, then you can go through any method. But it will be wise for you if you learn all the methods, okay? Because certain questions demand certain techniques. Okay, first the substitution method. Substitution method. Substitute means what? In place of, suppose there are two questions. In place of x, I am using sending. In place of y, I am sending x. Or in place of x, I am sending y. This is the substitute. Okay. In class, so whenever there is a proxy, some substitute feature is to do. Whenever the original feature is absent, same kind of thing. And I am pretty sure that you have came across that sort of different calculation in class 7. Okay. So from the exercise, I have selected two questions. Nine to two questions, others are similar, so only first and some particular number, I don't know its number. You please check it. I will try to show two different questions, two questions using substitution method. Okay? And then you practice it by you. Okay, the first question is this 2C2I. You can find this. Solve by substitution method. The first question is x plus y equals to 7. And second is twice x minus twice y equals 11. Okay, it is visible. Yes, x plus y equals 7 and twice x plus minus twice y equals 11. And to inform you one thing, see, whenever you put down such a good equation from the question paper or book, be very careful. Because a particular change in this operation will keep you away from getting good marks. Now see, you have to find what the values of x and y. Okay. The value of x and y that will satisfy this both the equations. Now, substitution method. Okay, I'll show you how we can do this. Now see, first equation x plus y equal to 7. Okay. Here it is given twice x minus thrice y equal to 11. Okay. Now since the x and y values are not unknown, so we don't have any values of x and y. In this case, we have to consider the value of x from a particular equation, or consider the value of y from a particular equation. Now see, if I use the value of x, then what will be the x? X will be what? The y will be 2, that side will become minus. So x, the value of x is 7 minus 1. Fine. This is equation number 1. Now you can give this equation 1, equation 2, equation 3. Okay, it's up to you. I prefer it to be equation 1. Now see, the value of x is with us. The value of x, we have calculated the value of x. Although no structure values coming, but the value of x is here. What is the value of x? The value of x is 7 minus 1. Okay. Now the value of x is with us. With this particular value, I am going to solve this. Now see, put the value of x. Okay, it is not mandatory to use only x. It's up to you whether you choose x or y. Fine. Whether you can choose x x, then x will be 7 minus y. If you are choosing y as the value, then it will be 7 minus x. Same answers will come out. Fine. Now put this value of x in this equation number 2. This particular equation. Now what is the equation? I will prefer writing here. I'll use this case. Now see, the next equation is twice x minus twice y equal to 11. Fine. Now see, from this equation 1, we have got the value of x. We can simply write here, putting the value of x. What is the value of x? X is 7. 2 into 7 minus y, then minus twice y equal to 11. You solve this, you get the value of y. After getting the value of y, we can also get the value of x. Very easy. This is 14 minus twice y minus twice y equal to 11. So it is minus 5y equal to 11 minus 14. So it will be minus 3. Fine. So the value of y is minus minus is becoming plus, so y equal to 3 by 5. Okay. So what is the value of y? The y is equal to 3 by 5. Now using this particular y value, you try to calculate x. Now, okay, now equation 1 implies, you write in this manner, equation 1 implies, which one is equation 1? Because this is the equation number 1. So here we are going to
okay.
Equation. Now equation 1. Equation 1 is how much? X equal to 7 minus 1. Fine. What is y? Y is 3 by 5. So minus 3 by 5. You calculate this,
it will be 35 minus 3. 35 minus 3 is 32 by 5. So answer is 32 by 5.
So x is 32 by 5, y is 3 by 5. So this is the answer. So roots of the equations are?
The roots of the equations are 32 by 5 and 3 by 5. Fine. So this is a particular example I showed you. Now question, next question I have taken is, okay, check this question.
Question number 2D is, okay, it is on the substitution method. So the same process we are going to apply. In the first step, you find this, what is the value of x? So it will be x equal to 1 plus 5y by 3 is 5. So the value of x, you simply put it here. So this is, this time I am considering this to be 1, this is 2, and this is 3. Fine. Now, but similarly, we are going to put the value of x here. So, the value of x you can directly put. What is the value of x? 1 plus 5y by how much? 3 plus twice y equal to 9. Calculate this. This is 5 plus 25y by 3 plus 10 y, so it is not 10, it is 2 y equal to 9. Fine. Now do the this word, 5 plus 25 y plus 6 y equal to 27. Fine. Now see, the y part is available first. For 25 y plus this 6, 31. 31y equal to 25 minus 5 is 23. Okay. So y is 22 by 31. So the value of y is 22 by 31. Now y is in our hand, so we can very nicely we can calculate the x. Therefore, x equal to how much? 1 plus 5 into 22 by 3 divided by, sorry, it is 22 by 31. divided by 3. So this is what you will do.
After solving this, you will get the answer
like this. So this is 31 plus 1 is here, this 31 and 22 is 110 and this 31 can multiply with this 3 is become 93, so it will be 1 4 1 by 93. So the rules of the equations are x is how much, x is 141 by 93, and this y is 22 by 31.
Okay, I think the things become clear to you. Fine. So with this particular two explanation, I'll stop the substitution method and I'll go to another method, that is elimination method. So the next question will be on elimination method. You please check this question. Okay, see, I have taken two questions of elimination method.
I think elimination method is more easier than the substitution method. The substitution method requires a lot of calculation. Eliminate means what? Eliminate means out of these two variables you have to remove one. Then in that manner we can calculate the both the rules, the value of x and y. Okay. Now it's up to you which variable you want to eliminate. Eliminate means you understanding? You have to eliminate one of the particular two variables. Now see here. First of all, you check the question. Without any difficulty, which variable can be eliminated? You check it. X is positive, y is negative. Okay, 6 is the correct answer. Here we check x is positive, y is positive. Okay, the technique is what? Elimination. Fine. That is very clearly given. See, if you try to add this both the equation, what will happen? 1 is positive, 1 is negative. That is, y is very easily going to get cancelled out and we will get x1. Okay? This is equation 1 and it is equation 2. So, when you get the value of x, very easily you can get the value of y also. So, you see, what I am going to do? I am simply going to add both the equations. When I add both the equations, that means this part will get added to this part. So, x plus x minus y plus x plus y. Fine. In some cases, like if here one minus is given, suppose minus y minus is given, then you check whether you do. It is not always mandatory to add the equations. The type of operation will be totally depend upon the equations. Some equations demand what for addition, some equations demand subtraction. It totally depend upon the equation. Another equation is in no similar. Here you do some kind of multiplication. Only then you can solve this. Let's check this. X minus y plus x plus y. It is equal to 6 plus 0. So positive y and negative y get cancel out. So what do you mean twice x? So twice x is equal to 6. Then the value of x is what? 3. Very easily we are able to find it. Now since we have got the value of x, now very easily we can got the value of y also. Whether you can put here also you have to use. Same answer we will get. So better to put here. Equation 2. Okay. Don't know like this will be right. Putting the value of x in equation 2. Putting value of x in equation 2. Okay. You can choose your own equation. The equation which is very easy or very simple, that equation in the group. Now, what is the equation? X plus y equal to 0 and x is how much? X is 3 plus y equal to 0. So, y is how much? Minus 3. Fine? So, y is minus 3, x is plus 3. This is satisfying both the equations. Fine? Okay, this is how very easily and very nicely we can do the elimination method. Okay. And if I specify you, to follow a particular procedure, follow a particular rule while doing this type of equation, then you have to do this. Else, if it is given only so bit, then you can go with any. Fine. I am coming to the next one. You see. Oh, one thing, come here. The earlier equation which I was doing in substitution method, I think I have modified the equation. You check, the question is not similar with the book question. In book it was given 99, it was 9, okay? So don't get confused after seeing the picture. Now, how we are going to do this? 7, we cannot find 7 here. 6, we cannot find 6 here. Both terms are having 4 only. Now, what we can do? See, only hint is this. Y is negative, here y is positive. That means very easily we can do this. That means we can simply add this and we can solve this. Now see, the first term, but the first thing you should do is making both the term which you have selected. Okay, it is not mandatory that only y should be. Totally up to you. I am finding in my first instance the y is coming because one is negative, one is positive. So when I add both the term, it will get cancelled out. If I am able to make it what? Easy. Fine. Now, how I can make the both terms equal? That is the main thing. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2. Okay. I am focusing on this y and only y term. Now see, 1 and 4. Okay, oh sorry, 6 and 4. So 6, this term when multiplied with 4, I will get 24. This term when multiplied with 6, then also I will get 24. So plus 24 and minus 24 will cancel out. So what is my first trick? The first trick is that I am trying to make two terms equal. So equation number 1 I will multiply with 4. Okay? That means the entire equation you have to multiply. Now 4 into 7 is 28 minus 6 4 is 24 y and 25 4 is 100. Okay, this is equation number 3. Similarly, equation 2 into how much? 6 with you. Fine. Equation is 6. Now one thing I like to add. See, if it was already 24, suppose the question is like this, if it was already 24, then I am not going to multiply any term. Okay. Now, in order to make both of them equal, I am multiplying both the equations. Now, if the equation is changed, then we will check it. How to proceed, where to multiply. Okay. Now, here also, it is 24x plus 24y. You can get to multiply, sorry, 6, yes. It is 6, 306. So, equation number 4. So, both the equation have been modified to 3 and 4. Now, you simply add this 3 plus 4. Or you can add in this manner also, if you like. But because this were cancelling and what remains is 3, it is 12, it is 4, it is 5, 52x equal to 406. X equal to 406 by 50. So this is the part of the answer we need. Okay? Yes? Fine. And if you like, you can solve this. It is 2, it is 6, it is 203. 203 and 26 is not going to divide by any number.
Okay, the video was stopped due to some technical problems.
Okay, see, I have done this. You find the value of x. The value of x is 203 by 26. Okay, we have got the value of x. Now what we are going to do? I am going to choose any of the equation out of these 4. It is not that I have modified these 2 equations. That means I have to use only this equation. It is not that. So you choose any equations to find the value of y. I am finding it to be suitable because it is containing simpler numbers. So you are putting the value of x in equation 2. What is the equation 2? This is the equation 2. 4x plus 4 by 2 51, x you put 203 by 26. So instead of x I put 203 by 26 plus 4 into y, and we have to find the value of y, and this will come. And you do this, it is simple. If I give me the answer in the infinity plus, okay. So in today's video we have completed substitution method and elimination method. There are two more methods, comparison and cross multiplication. Both are easy only. By next video I will complete both the process, and after that you can go through any. Okay, one more work for you. Try to apply the elimination method in substitution method also, and you check whether you are capable of winning the equations or not. Fine. Okay, then you finish the rest of the questions, and if you got any doubt, please let me know in the interactive class and in our group also. Okay.